Hey, Marcus Washington, MTC Media, Georgetown, UConn pregame. As you can see, teams are out early, warming up, getting in that pre-stretch before everyone gets out here, getting some shots up. And, you know, for Georgetown, again, they're coming off a tough loss. This time to the hands of Seton Hall on the road the other night. Another one of those games where it was going down towards the end. And Georgetown just could not get over the hump. Once again, for UConn has won. Let's see. UConn has not lost since December 20th, which was a loss to Seton Hall, which was the game where Klingon gets hurt. And that's not to take anything away from Seton Hall, because Seton Hall might have won that game anyway. They were playing so well. But that was the game that Klingon got hurt. So they have won, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 in a row. And with trips to Georgetown here today and DePaul after that. So for UConn, obviously for them, is to keep rolling. It's to not overlook Georgetown in a spot where it's a noon early start. You're playing a team that's been on the struggle bus of late. And for Hurley, it's just keeping their guys focused with their eyes on the prize. For Georgetown, though, it's a little bit different. Georgetown is still looking to grab some sort of momentum and get something going to show that there's progress in this program under first-year head coach Ed Cooley. Georgetown has lost 2, 4, 6, 7 in a row. And it's going to be tough to try to break that seven-game losing streak against the number one team in the country. But there are some things that this week that Cooley's worked on. Being able to operate deeper into a shot clock, being patient in the half-court offense, to limit possessions and to get the best shot, and also to limit runouts. Limit bad shots early in the shot clocks that serve as first passes to your opponent's fast breaks. So they worked on that this week. Look for Georgetown to really try to space the floor on offense and attack in that space. They have some guys that they think that can win some of those battles in space. So look for Georgetown to do that today. And defensively, look for the Hoyas to try to mix things up a little bit. I'm sure you're going to see zone today. Obviously, you're going to see your standard man. I don't know how much four-court stuff you'll see, but you'll see some zone along with their standard man today. And this is not, for Georgetown, it's not an individual thing. It's not a, if this person plays well, or if this person does this or that. Now, they do need guys to score. They need Jaden Epps to score, but they also need Jaden Epps to be a very, very good facilitator, which I thought he did against Seton Hall. Georgetown only had 5 turnovers against Seton Hall, and let's be honest, they had 4 of those early. So Epps did a great job, or a solid job, not a great job, a solid job as a facilitator. That helped Dontre Styles, who scored 20 points. That helped him get some shots off, put up some numbers that we saw early in the season where, you know, by the time we get to the midseason, it's like he had disappeared off the offensive end. Spoke to Cooley about that. Cooley's like, well, you're a great offensive player, the ball will find you. And sometimes, you know, your offense and your teammates got to help find you too. It can't always be on the player. But I understand what Cooley is saying. Obviously that, and Supreme Cook not getting in foul trouble. He's going to be going up against Klingon today. He can't get into foul trouble. And on top of that, he's been a double-double machine. It's to have a big double-double today. So for Georgetown, again, it's not necessarily individual. It's more team. And for UConn, it's not necessarily individual either. It's more of don't let this be your trip-up game. Okay? Georgetown, UConn, noon, I believe on FS1.